Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Today is July 15th, 2022. And yesterday on the 14th, which would have been Thursday, at 6:19 p.m. local time, there was a magnitude 4.6 earthquake near Ridgecrest, California. It was close to the same area where they had the magnitude 7.1 in 2019. Part of the Walker Lane seismic zone. 394 people said they felt the earthquake. USGS gave it an intensity level of 5. And it was reported over a very large area near Henderson, Nevada, Las Vegas. We got it all the way down here to Santa Ana, Long Beach, Oceanside, all the way up north. Let's see here. We'll zoom in. Clovis, California. What do we got here? Porterville, Tulare. I think that's what it says. Oh, Tulare. Okay. And then we got Springville. Another report from Springville. So intensity level 5 means it was felt by most people. There'd be breakage of dishes, things falling off the walls, windows might have broke, and cracks in plaster. You might check your foundation and gas and water lines. Tall objects might have fallen over also. There was quite a few foreshocks before yesterday's 4.6 earthquake. They did not fudge about the size of the earthquake. They were accurate. Here's an image of the spectrogram, and down below, let me bring it down so you can see. It was in fact a magnitude 4.66. And let me bring us back up. And I'll close this so you can see there was in fact earthquakes prior to this 4.6. Just like the 7.1, there was a lot of foreshocks before the 7.1 in 2019. They did not realize at the time that they were, in fact, foreshocks for the larger one, which was July, let me look here, 3rd. There was multiple foreshocks. And then later, the 7.1, they just thought there were small shocks, but doing their research. And this, too, was along the Walker Lane. Then they had a magnitude 6.4 the next day. That 27,540 people said they felt. That was an intensity level of 8. And then the 7.1 was an intensity level of 9. 24,382 people reported feeling that one. That was the 7.1. Oops. So we got intensity level 9 and 8. That would mean panel walls thrown out of their frame. Falling of walls, monuments, chimneys would have been blowholes. Sand and mud ejected out of the ground. Drivers of automobiles disturbed. I believe 2 people died. One where the car jack fell and crushed a guy, and another one I think was a heart attack. Intensity level 9, buildings shifted off their foundations. Cracked, thrown out a plumb, grounds cracked, underground pipes broke. Yeah, the water lines and gas lines didn't just crack, they actually broke. The actual uplift of the ground was actually there at the naval base, and USGS and other scientists were not allowed access to the naval base, but they did, you know, get access to some areas with the military personnel, you know, coming with them. And as you know, this is a volcanic field where hydrothermal energy is being created. Here is the location of yesterday, last night's a 4.6 earthquake. And I'll bring it out and we'll show you the area for the 7.1 right there. And this is the area the day later for the 6.4. And this is part of the Walker Lane seismic zone. Eventually, it will be the dominant fault zone. Right now, it takes, I believe, 25-35% of the strain of the movement of the plates. The San Andreas Fault takes up 75, somewhere in there, percentage of the stress. And I got drawn out here the different directions for the Walker Lane seismic zone. And just like the 7.1, today's 4.6, there was foreshocks. I downloaded data from two different monitors. In the last 24 hours, there has been 28 earthquakes in this location. And you can see a lot of them along this main fault. That was the one that originally ruptured. And then later, it triggered the rupture for the Garlock fault zone. That's... bring this over, and there's the 4.6. Let me close this out. We got a 1.5, the most recent, at 8:29 universal. 8:29 universal time, which would be this earthquake right there. You see, we got two here. There's two more very small ones before it, and we got a small one afterwards right there. Another small one before it, and another small one before, and I'll go ahead another 4 hours. This one here is at 8:29. That one there. Okay, and we'll go ahead. And yeah, see this? We got one, two, yeah, you want to count the little ones? Three, four, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13. Now these are all after the 4.6. And I'll go ahead here another. There's the 4.6. Okay, and it shows up on both monitors. We got two, three small ones before it. And we'll go ahead another 4 hours, which is actually going back in time. Yeah, some fairly decent sized ones. You can see it there on both monitors. Some of them. The one monitor at the bottom, GMR, is quite a ways from the location of Ridgecrest and Walker Lane. Go back another 4 hours because I want to show you something right here. Okay, the top one is China Lake. The bottom one is Granite Mountain Research Center. See this line right here? Let me pull it back a little bit. Okay, this here was an earthquake all the way over by New Zealand, New Guinea, and it made the earth ring like a bell. So yeah, it probably had something to do with triggering earthquakes here, and probably to do with earthquakes in other parts of the world. Yeah, see that? Here on this helioplot, shows the earthquake Tarawa Island, which would be, let me go here, right there. And there's Papua New Guinea. This one here is a 5.1 at, that was a 5.1 near Vanuatu. And yeah, there's been all kinds of large earthquakes. Here we got one by Tonga, 5.0, a 6.0. For Vanuatu. Yeah, this whole area has just been rocking and rolling lately. So here we have Arizona. We got Indiana. Over on the right here is Tennessee. Ohio. You can see as the seismic signature came in. Michigan. Yeah. Texas. New York City. Bring it down a little bit. Oregon. Montana. It really shows up on the monitor for GMR. I'll show you where that's at. Right there. And then the other monitor is over here. This is for China Lake. Right there. That's the other one. And we'll go back to the location of the 4.6 so you can see it. Yeah, right in here. Right there. The largest aftershocks would have been at 539. Here it is for the borehole. Now, I want to explain. This is a borehole. It's a very deep well under the ground. Borehole 917. And this is the other one that shows a seismic wave. And we'll take a look at the signature. And that would be a magnitude 2.3. And they did not fudge about the size of that one either. Yeah, in fact, it was a magnitude 2.32. So they told the truth about that one. For those of you on laptops or might be watching it on a larger computer, you can see at the bottom it says MD 2.32. And that would be this earthquake right there, if you're looking at it on the stream view. Now, as usual, there's several that they haven't reported. They did report the one at 407 and 420, which would be 407 there, 420 there. This one they did not report. That one they did not report. And the other ones that were very small, like that one, they did not report. This one they did report at 318, and this one at 354 they reported too. But it looks like all these foreshocks, such as this one at 1855, 2045, 1930, yeah, I'm just rounding it off, 2025, and 1911 or 12, none of those foreshocks did they report, not a single one. And you can see them here. We got on the right, I can't pull it. Okay, 1854. Yeah, a long P wave on it. And then we got another one over here. Let's see. 1930. There's the one at 1931. Yeah, they did not report that. It too's got a long P wave on it. So I don't know. There's its seismic signature, and we'll go to this one. And I'll pull it over and show you the seismic signature on this one. Like I said, this one here was caused by the earthquakes there along the Ring of Fire. And this is 1845, and then this one is the 4.6. Yeah, it really rock and rolled. Yep. So anyways, when the 7.1 happened, it triggered earthquakes along the Walker Lane, and then it also triggered earthquakes along the Garlock Fault Zone. Yeah, and they say that that 7.1 reactivated the Garlock Fault Zone. There's the 7.1, there's a 6.4 afterwards. Yeah, and they did not know at the time that the swarm of small earthquakes prior to the 7.1 were in fact foreshocks. That's what they call them, foreshocks. And this is the Garlock Fault Zone. So what are your thoughts? Did you feel this 4.6? Like I said, you have a 20% chance any earthquake can be a foreshock for something much larger. Are you prepared? Do you have a plan? Do you have supplies and medical and food? And don't forget the pets. Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Boy, you guys are just wonderful in your support. If you do want to support me, I'm on Patreon. You can join for as little as $1 a month. Or all you have to do is subscribe or even just share my videos. Thank you again. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.